Hello everybody and welcome to the Rise of the PyWomen World 2. Today we will talk about Seaborn. So this is introduction to Seaborn. We're going to briefly go over what Seaborn is, how to install it on your computer, and how to find official documentation. Seaborn is a statistical plotting library, and it's built on top of Matplotlib. So what is Matplotlib? Matplotlib is a Python 2D plotting library which produces publication quality figures in a variety of hard copy and interactive environments across platforms. Matplotlib can be used in Python scripts, the Python and IPython shells, the Jupyter notebook that we are using today, and web application servers and four graphical user interface toolkits. Matplotlib tries to make easy and hard things possible. You can generate plots, histograms, power spectra, bar charts, error charts, scatter plots, etc. with just few lines of code. Seaborn has really beautiful default styles, and it's also designed to work really well with Pandas data frame objects. You'll need to install it with conda or pip at your command line or terminal with conda install pip or pip install seaborn. So let's get a quick tour at the official Seaborn website. I'm going to Google and I will show you how to get official documentation. So all right, here I am. I'll go now to Google. Here we are. So all right, so in order to find the link to the official documentation, since Seaborn is open source, it's hosted on GitHub, you can go and say GitHub Seaborn Python. Click on this first line link. On this page, you can actually read all the codes since it's open source as far as statistical library, but more importantly, you can scroll down. And you can see the online documentation that is available here. So we will click here. So this is the official documentation of Seaborn. So now something that is really nice about this official documentation page is just like at the official documentation of Matplotlib is like gallery. Note, so I wouldn't use this gallery as a reference. It's just of a couple of examples of what Seaborn can do. So for example, today we will make like violin plot. So for example, so you can see how violin plot looks like. Or today we will go and make, let me see, we will make also like box plot. So you can see here. Also we will make heat map, also join plot. You can see heat map here. So you can go and click on some of these pictures and you can see how Seaborn is really powerful tool for visualization. So Seaborn is really good looking visualization library. The other really important link beside gallery is the API. So the API reference. API reference is basically a reference to the various plot types here. This is what we are going to be going over as we learn how to use Seaborn. we are going to really effectively learn how to actually call these plots and utilize pandas for these plots and create really nice statistical plot visualization. So great. So we will, during this couple of days, so we will go through all of these plots. Today we will go and do categorical plots, and tomorrow we will also cover these other plots as well. So let's go ahead and jump actually to the quick tour and like going to code Seaborn. So let's go and hop to code and to make that visualization. I have prepared template in Jupyter notebook for today. You can download it using link below on YouTube. So okay, here I'm at the Jupyter notebook, and I've already put in a couple of lines of code here. I said like import Seaborn as SNS, and also ahead I said matplotlib inline inside, so that means I can see the visualizations inside of the Jupyter notebook. Then I went ahead and loaded the tips dataset, and then I checked out the head of the dataset. So okay, so for categorical plots, we're mainly going to be concerned about seeing the distributions of a categorical column, such as this sex, gender, or smoker, or day, or time, in reference either to one of the numerical data, so total beer or tip. So columns on another categorical column. So let's go ahead and start off with the most basic categorical plot, which is the bar plot. So bar plot is just a general plot that allows you to aggregate the categorical data based off of some function, and by default that's the mean. You can almost think of this as a visualization of a group by action. So let me show you what I mean by that. So we are going to go in and set x and epsilon and data arguments into bar plot all sort of. So let's say SNS dot bar plot x equals y equals, and like of course data equals. So I will start with data because that's the easiest. So data equals tips, and I will set x axis to categorical column. I will choose sex, and for y axis I will choose a numerical column, so I will say total bill. Yeah, and this will create a bar plot, and by default what this is showing, so this is showing here you have the average of mean of the total bill per categorical column value. The average total bill for males is going to be slightly higher than the average total bill for females. You can go ahead and change what's known as the estimated object if you want to basically affect what the actual grouping or aggregation here is. We can go and do that by adding another argument here. So we can add here like estimator equals, so estimator equals. So estimator is a function that is an aggregate function, statistical function to estimate within each categorical bin. By default, that's going to be average or mean. I can also put in my own function. So right now we're looking at mean total bill. But let's say we wanted to figure out the standard deviation for genders. For instance, is there more standard deviation on males and their total bill? So more variance, or do females have more variance? So we are going to get into and say before this, so we will insert a cell above. So we will say so we will say import numpy as np, import numpy as np, okay. So then in the estimator, I'm going to pass, so np.std, that's equals to standard deviation. So, and it will tell me, so what will tell me? So it will tell me what the standard deviation of the total bill column is per category. So you can pass it in whatever estimation function you want. So you can even create your own. So you can pass it into bar plot, where x is a category column and y is some soft numerical column. Then you will pass your data and whatever estimator you want. So this is just an aggregate and essentially just a visualization of some sort of group by mechanism here. So let's go and add more counterplot. So we will now talk about counterplot. So counterplots in Seaborn is essentially the same as bar plot, except the estimator. So estimator is explicitly counting the number of occurrences. Because of that, we only set the x value and then we set the data. So y value is added automatically. So we will say here SNS dot count plot x equals and then data equals tips. And we will run it. So this is essentially the same thing. So basis of count plot. So we can see here that there are more males than females in the data set. And next we will talk about box plot. So this is the easiest part of the visualization in Seaborn. So the next step, box plots and violin plots, are used to show the distribution of categorical data. So a box plot or a box and whiskey plot shows the distribution of quantitative data in a way that facilitates comparisons between variables or across levels of categorical variable. The box shows the quartiles of the dataset, while the whiskers extend to show the rest of the distribution, except for points that are determined to be outliers, using a method that is function of the inner quartile range. So these types of plots are used to show that distribution of categorical data. A box plot is sometimes is known as previously said, a box and a whiskey plot. It shows distribution of quartile data in a way that hopefully facilitates comparison between the variables. So let me show you what I mean by that. So I'm going to create a box plot by saying SNS dot box plot x equals day, y equals total bill. Of course, then we will give our data, so data equals tips, and then, so I will choose X to be a categorical data, as you saw, and Y is going to be a numerical, so pass the data as tips, and go ahead and run it. So I will run this now. Okay. So this bus plot shows the quartiles of the dataset while the whiskies extend to show the rest of the distribution, except for these points that are outside of these whiskies, and they are called outliers. And you can essentially just interpret this as from, for instance, if you look at Thursday as a day by itself, we have the y-axis total bill, and then on x-axis is just separated by category on or day. If I look at this blue one right here, all the way on the left from Thursday, it's essentially telling me that about 25% or a quarter, which is why these are called quartiles. Or are the data points go from the center of the whiskey to the bottom here, and then another quarter go from the bottom of the box to the middle here, and then extend to the top. These dots, as I previously said, are outliers, and we can begin to get really fancy with Seaborn by just adding a few more words of code here and specify a hue. So we will add here a hue. So we will say hue. So we will add another categoric column. So let's say smoker. Okay. So if I run this now, I will see as I run it, I see the box plot splits per day and also split by smoker stats. And smoker stats is colored for you, so you can say blue is for yes, for smokers, and like orange is for non-smokers. So you can now compare day-by-day behavior for total bill, but also by whether or not this person is a smoker or non-smoker. This is really true power behind Seaborn. It quickly allows you to add this hue indicator, which essentially gives you another layer of data very quickly and very smoothly. You can compare that basically people on Friday tend to have a larger bill if they are not a smoker versus if they are a smoker. You can begin to actually see the variation for smokers, or that distribution for smokers and non-smokers. So it's really nice visualization. So now let's go and talk about violent plots. So I will go ahead and remove this hue, so we can have our basic box plot from the beginning. Okay. And let's go. So violent plot plays a similar role as a box plot and whiskies plot. It shows the distribution of quantitative data across several levels of one or more categorical variables, such that those distribution can be compared. Unlike a box plot, in which all of the plot components correspond to actual data points, the violent plot features a kernel density estimation of the underlying distribution. So what this definition is all about. So it's going also to show the violent chart. So first of all, I will go and type. It's easier that way. So I will say SNS dot violent plot x equals, as previously, day, y equals total bill,
data equals tips, and let's go and run it. Okay. And so it's going also to show, as you can see, it's going also to show the distribution of a data across some sort or category. It's going to take exact some arguments as box plot. So we have a box plot on this side, so on the top, and while in plot on the bottom. So while in plot allow us to actually plot all the components that correspond to actual data points or columns, and it's essentially showing the kernel density estimation of the underlying distribution. So this is essentially just showing, if we kind of split this in half, the distribution of the points on its side. This allows you to reveal even more information about the data points themselves. So the cost comes at the fact that it's a little harder to interpret or read versus a box plot. So box plot is very easy to just take a look, and you can quickly tell where roughly the data compares on a category. In violent plot, another case, so will just give you a lot more information as far as the distribution of all the points themselves. These two plots are very related to each other. Just violent plot shows a little more information as I previously said. Sometimes this info can be even hidden from you if you are just using a box plot. And a violent plot, just like the box plot, also has the option to do hue. So hue equals, again, let's say sex, and we can go and run it. Okay. So what's interesting about the violent plot versus the box plot is as another argument, instead of putting two violent plots next to each other, we have violent charts, one from each other on the side. So what's interesting about the violent plot versus the box plot is, as another argument, instead of putting two violent plots next to each other, since the violent plot information essentially doubled up, I could have one half, one here, and one half on one here. So I don't need to have two of them. So what could I do now? You can do that by saying like split. So you can say here, like, okay, split, and then equals true. Okay, so you now have that, so it will kind of split, so you can see that it will kind of split distribution. So here you have a lot of more information, and you can directly compare the distributions based off in another category and see how the categories themselves on the x-axis compare to each other. This comes again at the cost that you are going to spend more time looking at this visualization. So you really have to know your audience and know what's appropriate when you are using Seaborn, this advanced visualization. So if you are showing this to another data scientist, this violet chart will be really good. Also, violet plot will be really good for it. But however, for dealing with kind of CEOs or like decision makers people, so maybe a box plot will be a better solution because they didn't saw a violent plot. So let's go and talk about more advanced methods for visualization, this sort of categorical data. So we'll start with three plot. It is probably the simplest from others. So streamplot will draw a scatter plot where one variable is categorical. A streamplot can be drawn on its own, but it's also a good complement to a box or violent plot in cases where you want to show all observations along with some representation on the underlying distribution. So, and also we have, after that, we have a swarm plot. It is similar to strip plot, but the points are adjusted only along the categorical axis so that they don't overlap. This gives us a better representation of the distribution of values, although it does not scale as well to large numbers of observations, both in terms of the ability to show all the points and in terms of the computation needed to arrange them. So streamplot. So we will start with streamplot. So it's probably the simplest, as I previously said. So we'll go sns.streamplot, and it's the same as in the previous. So x is categorical and categorical column, and y is numerical, so it will be again total bill, and of course data equals tips, and we will run it. Okay, so streamplot, so you can see streamplot draw a scatter plot where one variable is categorical, and we are going to do, you can say, we did the same stuff that we did in previous for violent plot and so on. So this is just essentially a scatter plot based off the category. So one issue with this strip plot that you can't really tell how many points are stacked on top of each other, which you can do is add another argument called jitter. So what jitter will do for you, so we could go, if we go here and say jitter equals true, and okay, so jitter equals true, and we run it. It's, so you can see that it's so the jitter did it, that add a little random noise to separate some of these stacked points. And you can see the ticker and more points there are a lot more clear versus just the normal tree plot. Normal tree plot, if he had a bunch of points stacked on top of each other, it's kind of hard to tell. So, but now if you can see the density of a little better in with the tree plot, just like a violent plot, you can begin adding some of those extra few arguments. So again, we can do and say, hue, so we can do, say, okay, hue equals, so again we can say sex, so gender, so then go, and okay, and so this will basically, you can see it split up these colors based off your hue argument. So we have like blue is for male and orange is for female. You have to be careful with this strip plot because it is hard to interpret it. Some people like, but another point, like some people like to combine the strip plot and violent plot and create something that's known as swarm plot. So we can go here and so Seaborn allows you to do that. So we can go and type. So make a swarm plot, okay, as, so it's called swarm plot, okay, so we can go, so sns.swarm plot, and again it's the same. So x equals day, so categorical, y equals total bill. Again, data equals tips, and we can go and run it. So you can see it looks like a tree. So maybe this is a Christmas tree because we passed the new year. So you can see it's very similar to striplot, except the points are adjusted so that they don't overlap. So this gives you a better representation of distribution of values. But the swarm plot is essentially a combination of a triplot and one plot. It shows the same distribution, except it's actually showing all the points themselves. So I will advise not to use swarm plots for very large data sets, because this is it will be hard to interpret that kind of data. And so we can now combine, as we said, we can combine a categorical plot, so we can do and do this same. So we can so we will copy this and we can go here. Okay, so we will paste, and then we can go and do it the same way. So we can go in SNS. So island plot, and so it will be the same. So you can see tips, and then we can go and run it. So you can see I forgot to add a color, so we have to add a color here. So color equals black, because in order to see this. So you can see that you can combine categorical plots. So here you can see every single point and the corresponding KDE or kernel density estimation plot on top of it. But this is this is just an example that you can combine different categorical plots, and you can use this for your own purpose, but for presentation you shouldn't use this, because it's like a lot of information, more information that you really want. And for the end, we have a factor plot. So factor plot is the most general form of a categorical plot. So you can take a parameter to adjust the plot type. So you can go and write, so SNS factor plots, and then say the same stuff that we already said. So x equals day, and y equals total bill as in the previous, so total bill, and of course data equals tips. And then we will do add a kind, so you can interpret it the same. So the bars, we can here we want to add a bar plot, so we can say a bar, and then we will get a bar plot. So you can see that. So we can do also for another charts, so we can see here and add violin, so violin, and then we will got our own plot. So that's it. So this is just it for it's for categorical plots, and it creates so you want to recreate some of the charts and plots, we can do this, but really I don't, it's just for a extra knowing. But I really prefer, when I want to get a violin chart, I will go and add SNS that violin plot. So hopefully you saw a lot of the power of that's available to you, and use this power wisely, especially depending who you are representing to. Hope you enjoyed this today's vlog. So see you tomorrow, when we will do real exercise. So we will do Santa Claus dataset with Tableau, and also we will continue doing Seaborn visualization. So we will go through all the parts of Seaborn, so you will know Seaborn from the beginning to the end, so it will be like really good data visualization for you. So after like finishing visualization, we will after that go furthermore deeply into data science field and machine learning field. So until then, until tomorrow, happy whizzing, bye.